Hello students, welcome to all. In last video, we saw groups, abelian group and composition table. Okay, now today we are going to study some elementary properties of groups. So in that property, here we see uniqueness of identity, uniqueness of inverse, cancellation law and Saussure property. Okay, so now we start with the uniqueness of identity. Elementary properties of groups. Now, first we see the theorem. Uniqueness of identity. Statement: in A group G, there is only one identity element. Okay, so here we want to show that if G is a group, then there exists only one identity element, that is unique identity element. So we see the proof of this theorem. Proof. Now here we want to show that the identity is unique. So for showing this, here we suppose that two identity elements in G. So suppose we have two identity elements, say E and E dash in a group G. Okay, now here we suppose that there exist two identity elements in a group G, E and E dash. Now since E is the identity, element, we have, so here we know the definition of identity. If E is identity in group G, then A star E is equals to A. So here we use this proper definition here. A star E is equals to A for every A belongs to set G. Okay. Now here we substitute A is equals to E dash. Here we suppose that E dash is the element. Okay. So here we substitute A is equals to E dash. So we get E dash star E is equals to E dash, since A is equals to E dash. Okay. Now here we give it to the number first. Now E, here we suppose that E dash is the identity element. Identity element. So here we have, again by identity, A star E dash is equals to A, since here identity element is E dash. Okay. So substitute A is equals to E. So we get E star E dash is equals to E, and give it to the number second. Now from first and second, so see in equation first, here E dash star E is equals to E dash. Okay. And in equation second, E star E dash is equals to E. Okay. So that means we get E dash is equals to E. So here from 1 and 2, we get E dash is equals to E. That means there exists a unique identity element. Hence the proof. Okay, get it this? Okay. Now we see the next theorem. Cancellation law. Cancellation law. Okay, so theorem statement, let G be a group and A, B, C be elements in G, in group G. Then first B star A is equals to C star A, and this implies that B is equals to C, and this law is known as right cancellation law. Right cancellation law. Okay, now second law, here A star B is equals to A star C. This implies that B is equals to C. So this law is known as left cancellation law. Okay, now we see the proof of this theorem. Given that, so first given B star A is equals to C star A, and give it to the number first. Okay, now here we assume that A dash be the inverse of A. So let A dash be the inverse of A. Here given that G be a group, and in if it is a group, then there exists inverse of each element in group G. So that's why we consider A dash be the inverse of A. So then post multiplying by A dash on both sides of equation first. So here we post multiply by equation A by A dash. So we get B star A star A dash is equals to C star A star A dash. Okay, now next, this implies that here G is a group. So G is associative. So by associativity we interchange the brackets B star A dash is equals to C star in second bracket A star A dash, since star is associative. Okay, now here A star A dash is nothing but E. Okay, so we get B star E is equals to C star E, since A star A dash is equals to E. Now we know that B star E is equals to B and C star E is equals to C. So substitute here B is equals to C. So here we get B is equals to C. Required result, given that B star A is equals to C star A, and here by using left cancellation we get B is equals to C. Now similarly next, second law, given that A star B is equals to A star C, give it to the number second. Now see here, A star B is equals to A star C, and given that G be a group. So since it is a group, that means every element has inverse in G. So therefore, A dash be the inverse of A in G. So now here we pre-multiplying equation second by A dash, we get A dash star A star B is equals to A dash star A star C. Okay, now since G is group, that means star is associative. So by using associativity, A star A in first bracket star B. Similarly, here A star A in bracket star C, since star is associative. Okay, now we know that A dash star A, that is E, identity element. So E star B is equals to again E star C. Since A dash star A is equals to E. Now we know that E into any element, that element itself, since E is identity or we know that E star B and E star C is equals to B is equals to C. Okay, so here given that A star B is equals to A star C, and then we get B is equals to C. So this law is known as left cancellation law. Okay, get it this? Okay, now we see the next theorem. Here next theorem is uniqueness of inverse. Uniqueness of inverse. Okay, so statement, let G be a group and A be element in G, then there is unique element B in G such that A star B is equals to B star A is equals to E. Okay, so that is every element in group G has unique inverse. Okay, so here we want to prove that there exists unique inverse in group G. Okay, so proof. Now in this proof we want to prove that if inverse exists, then it is unique, right? So here we assume there exist two inverse of A, and we want to show that two inverse are equal. If they are equal, then this shows that there exist unique element B. Okay, so here we suppose that B and C are both inverses of element A, then we have, by definition of inverse, then we have A star B is equals to B star A is equals to E. Now C is also inverse, so we get A star C is equals to C star A equals to E. Okay, now here we want to show that these two inverse B and C are equal. So consider B. Now we know that B is equals to B star E by identity. Okay, so here E is equals to A star E. We substitute here A star C. B star A star C. Since A star C is equals to E. Okay, now since star is associative, we interchange brackets. Since star is associative. Okay, now here B star A is nothing but the identity element, so we get E star C. Write down reasons. Since B star A is equals to E. Now again E star C is equals to C. So here we get B is equals to C. That means there exists unique inverse, right? So this is the uniqueness of inverse. Get it? Okay. Now we see the next theorem, Sockshut property. Okay, now statement. Let G be a group and A be elements in G. Then A star B bracket inverse is equals to B star B inverse star A inverse. So see here, G be a group and AB belongs to group G. Then here A star B bracket inverse is equals to B inverse star A inverse. This property is called as Sockshut property. Okay, now proof. So here consider, now here we want to show that inverse of A star B is B inverse star A inverse. Okay, so here we know the property in inverse property, A B element in G and B is the inverse of A in G. Then A star B is equals to B star A is equals to E. So similarly, we use this property here. So we consider A star B star B inverse star A inverse. Okay, now here we want to show that this in this star this is equals to identity element. Okay, so here A star B inverse star A inverse, since star is associative. Okay, now B star B inverse is nothing but E. So we substitute here A star E star A inverse. Since B star B inverse is equals to identity element. Now A star E, E star A inverse is nothing but A star A inverse. Okay. So A star A inverse is nothing but the identity element. Since A star A inverse is equals to E. So therefore we get A star B is equals to A star B star B inverse star A inverse is equals to E. Okay, now in similar way we want to show that B inverse star A inverse star A star B is equals to identity element. So again consider बी इनवर्स, स्टार ए इनवर्स, स्टार ए स्टार बी, विच इज इक्वल्स टू, सिंस स्टार इज एसोसिएटिव सो इंटरचेंज ए इनवर्स स्टार ए स्टार बी, सिंस स्टार इज एसोसिएटिव. ओके, नाउ हियर बी इनवर्स स्टार, हियर वी नो दैट ए इनवर्स स्टार ए इज नथिंग बट द आइडेंटिटी एलिमेंट, सो वी सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर ई स्टार बी, सिंस ए इनवर्स स्टार ए इज इक्वल्स टू identity. Okay, so B inverse star E star B, then we get B inverse star B, and B inverse star B is nothing but identity element. Okay, therefore we get B inverse star A inverse star A star B is equals to E. So we get A star B, star B inverse star A inverse is equals to B inverse star A inverse star A star B is equals to E. So that's why A star B inverse is equals to B inverse star A inverse. Okay, get it? That is B inverse star A inverse is the inverse of A star B. Okay, get it this? Now we see next theorem. Let G be a group and AB be elements in G, then first the equation A star X is equals to B has unique solution X is equals to A inverse star B, and similarly second the equation Y star A is equals to B has unique solution Y is equals to B star A inverse. Okay, so here C statement, G be any group and AB belongs to G, then first the equation A star X is equals to B has unique solution X is equals to A inverse star B, and similarly second Y star A is equals to B has unique solution Y is equals to B star A inverse. So first here we want to check that A inverse star B is the solution of equation A star X is equals to B, and after that we prove the uniqueness of this solution. So see proof. So first we check that A inverse star B is the solution of equation A star X is equals to B. Okay, so consider A star X is equals to B. Now here we want to check this is solution, so substitute X is equals to this here. So here we get, so here we get, write down A star A inverse star B which is equals to B. Again, this implies since star is associative, so we get A star A inverse star B, which is equals to B. Now, here write down, since star is associative. Okay. Now, A star A inverse is nothing but the identity. So, identity star B is equals to B since A star A inverse is equals to B. Now, identity star B is B itself. So, B is equals to B. Here we get B is equals to B. That is A inverse star B is the solution of equation A star X is equals to B, right? Now we want to prove the uniqueness of this solution. Okay, so now prove uniqueness. So for uniqueness, here we want to assume that two solutions. Okay, so here we assume two solutions, x1 and x2. So suppose that there are two solutions, say x1 and x2 to the equation A star X is equals to B. Hence, we get A star x1 is equals to B and A star x2 is equals to B. Okay. So, see here, first solution is A star x1 is equals to B and second solution A star x2 is equals to B. So, from this two equals to B, right hand side equals to B. So, we get A star x1 is equals to A star x2. And here by left cancellation law, we get x1 is equals to x2. So, by left cancellation law, we get x1 is equals to x2. So that means here we prove that if there exists a solution, then that solution is unique. Okay, hence the proof. Okay, now today we stop here. Thank you.